supply of feeder combination, the RobustFeed Edge. This feeder has a completely different approach than we've had in the past. It's an advanced controlled unit, but when you look at the front, it looks like a basic unit, and that was the whole design. On the front panel, we have what you use every day, your main controls for wire feed speed, voltage and or trim, three memories, and process selection. After that, if all the heavier adjustments are done inside the feeder. This keeps the area that the welder needs to interact with on a daily basis simple and clean while still giving us high performance capabilities inside the feeder. Let's take a closer look at the front panel. We see here we have our general control knobs, and then we also have this icon in the middle. This tells us what process we're in. Currently we're in the speed process. That's one of our newest high speed welding applications. Also, we have this control down here for changing that process. So as we select this, we'll notice that we're jumping to different icons and different processes. So next in line would be stick welding, carbon arc gouging, back to standard MIG, and then all the other processes that are available. Once we get a process or a memory that we like for everyday use, we can assign it to the first three memories in the system, which we call jobs. And then we can call up these jobs by just simply pressing the button. If the process changes from where we're at, you'll see that this will update as we select different jobs. Inside the panel, I have the ability to store up to 20 jobs, but the ones that I can recall will stay in slots 1, 2, and 3. So a few other things you'll notice that it's set up on this feeder is the wheel kit. This is to run on the side. So we can also, once again, index this panel. So if we were running the wheel kit, we could utilize that and still be able to see all of our processes and our settings at a normal angle. Also, the case is IP54, so we got an even higher rating on the RobustFeed Edge family than the IP44 on the standard RobustFeed. Last but not least, this is a real game changer, is the RFID login and logout. We can set this up with user accounts using a card to access or limit the access that the operator or welder would have. So we have two main levels, welder, which would just be able to work through the jobs and won't be able to make too many high level adjustments on the inside, and an administrative card, which will unlock the entire unit. So I wanted to give you a better idea of what these user cards look like. Right here we have our admin and a user card. When we have the system without the cards, you'll notice that it just looks regular. If we use a user card to log in, once we tap it here, you'll see the icon pop up that lets you know we're in user mode. We can set this up a couple different ways. We can even have it to where this card will not allow this machine to run until the welder logs in. That'll make sure that we have proper access or proper use of this machine on the shop floor. If an admin comes by and it's in user mode and they tap their card, you'll notice that it unlocks it. They can make changes, do advanced settings, and when they go to leave, they can tap again and put it back in the user mode. So let's take a look at the inside control panel. This is where we take care of the more advanced settings for the unit. As we see here, it gives us an idea of what we're already set up on: carbon steel wire, 045 diameter, gas type, and the process that we're using. We can make adjustments in this menu by simply just clicking on each part and then adjusting using this scrolling knob here. Once we get there, it's hard to see, but we can click to select. I did select a carbon arc gouging mode, which will turn the contactor on, and it gives us a brief moment for safety to let us know that that's about to be activated. But let's go back to a MIG process, like speed, so we can just see the full menu. That's how we make simple adjustments. We can also make gas and diameter adjustments and wire type adjustments. So if we're on stainlesses, metal cores, flux cores, what have you, by simply clicking. You notice here, instead of our standard flow tube, we actually have a digital gas system built into this. This digital gas system helps us save money on our shielding gas. Standard shielding gas lines will build up a static pressure, and when initially starting the arc, a big rush of gas will come in. And this waste gas, it also can impact the quality of the weld. The system true flow technology inside this feeder has a system that compensates for that and gives us constant, consistent gas delivery. It'll also detect that if you have a line drop, perhaps a forklift runs over your cable set or someone accidentally shuts off your gas supply, the machine will shut down to prevent you from making a low quality weld. True flow is adjustable right here by simply clicking on the main control knob, and then we can adjust our flow rate up and down to match our procedure. Once we've got it to where we want it, we can just click off of it and we're ready to go. That's the main process setup. If we need to get into more advanced menus, we simply click our menu button. Now we can get into more advanced settings. Our weld settings will have stuff like burn back timer, pre-flow timers. Below that, we have our jobs, which is up to 20 jobs that we can save in the unit. The first three, once again, will be our soft keys on the front of the feeder. And then we also have tools and system settings. So let's take a look at weld settings. We click on that. It also gives us a rundown, once again, of where we're set at. So our wire feed speed, voltage, and so on. Our gas flow, it kind of puts everything that our process is being controlled at right at one screen. As we scroll down, we can see where we have our hot start control, pre-flow, creep start, and then we also have crater fill, gas post flow, and termination method, or burn back. To go backwards one screen, we simply click the back button, and it'll take us back one level. So now we can come down to our jobs. We can take a look at what that looks like, and we just simply click to select that. We have a few memories stored already in this unit. We don't have to go in order. We can store on memory 1, 2, and 3, and then different memories from there on out. But once again, these are our touch buttons on the front, our job buttons on the front of the feeder. If we want to come down and save a memory, simply select a open slot, and up here on this top key, you'll see a save button. Simply click, and it'll populate that into that memory. We also have additional options for editing settings, edit limits, and delete the job as well. So we can go in here and delete that job now. It'll make sure that you want to complete this task. We can confirm it, and the memory goes away. So we hit back again to get back out of these menus. And then last but not least, we can go into our system settings. Another nice feature about this is when we change out cable sets or perhaps different guns, true arc compensate. This is a simple procedure where we take the end of the gun off, the shielding nozzle off the end of the gun, and we touch the contact tip to the ground or the workpiece, and simply pull the trigger, and it'll measure the resistance in the system to make sure we're getting actual settings out at the arc. It'll prompt you from time to time to do this, and it's just a good way to make sure we're getting the highest quality welds. Next, we have front panel capabilities. Some of the knobs on the front panel are clickable to change settings, and we can turn on or off if that option is available. So if you want to give your operators advanced controls like arc dynamics, which has different functions and different processes, we can enable that, or we can keep them from being able to use that. We can also display estimated amperage if you want. Right now it's turned off. So for our trigger job shift, we can trigger it off of the torch itself, and we can decide to go between job 1 and 2 or between all 3 jobs on the front. Here we have remote configuration. Utilizing the exterior torch, we can now use controls out at the front end that the welder can use on the fly. And we can pick what we use by going into this menu. So we select here. It's asking us if we're going to pull up that torch. We select that, and then it gives us the different settings that we can run off of that torch. Also, at the bottom of this, we can change different languages, plenty of different languages in there. Unit of measure, if you do run into a job where you're going to be running metric for whatever reason. And there's also a date and time clock in here, so you can make sure that as you couple this with Weld Cloud or take event logs out of the system, having this on the correct date and time will help us figure out exactly when these things happen or when welding occurred on the shop floor.